Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do sky replacements in Photoshop. This tutorial is actually part of my Amazon.com collection. I was recently invited to post video tutorials to Amazon Video Shorts, which is part of the Amazon Instant Video platform. All of my tutorials there are free, and they're either completely new or shorter versions of some of the tutorials that you have seen on this YouTube channel. If you want to see the rest of my Amazon Video Shorts, go to ptcvids.com/Amazon or look at the description below for the link. And don't worry, I'll still keep updating this YouTube channel just as before. Nothing will change here. And talking about YouTube, I would also like to take this opportunity to thank you. I just received a plaque from YouTube for reaching 100,000 subscribers. Thank you again for all your support. I really do appreciate it. But anyway, back to the tutorial. As I already mentioned, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do sky replacements in Photoshop. First, we have our original image, and what we want to do is we want to replace the sky. The first step is to find a different image with the sky that you like, but you have to make sure that the perspective matches. What I mean by that is that when you select an image, for example, this one here, this one wouldn't work because this image was taken with the camera pointing straight up at the clouds. So the perspective is not going to match the image of the street that we're working with. As you can see there, once I've added the cloud into this composition, it just doesn't work because we don't have the right perspective and also the scale is off. So we have to find an image whose perspective matches our original image and that we can scale appropriately. This image here has some nice clouds. We see the horizon line here at the bottom, which is going to be important in placing the clouds on this image. You can see the horizon line here. So what we can do is use this image here, and you don't have to be exact and match the horizon lines. You can be off a little bit, but as long as they're very similar horizon lines, you shouldn't have a problem with perspective. So I'm going to place these clouds here. There's a lot of ways in which you can mask in Photoshop. Sometimes you don't need to mask at all. You can use something called a blend if sliders to create the mask in order to combine two images together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to enable this layer, clouds one, and double click to the right of that layer to bring up the layer style window. From here, I can play around with the blend if sliders to blend these two layers together. The blend if sliders allows us to hide parts of the current layer to reveal parts of the bottom layer by using these sliders that you see here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in the blend if and choose blue. Then I'm going to click on this slider and drag that to the right. And you'll notice that the image will start appearing, but the sky remains intact. One of the downsides is that by using the slider, the transitions are very hard. But what you can do is you can hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click on the slider, it splits it in two, and you can separate that slider to make a smoother transition. If you go too far, the clouds will start disappearing. So you gotta find the balance in between the foreground and background. As you can see here, we're having some issues here, but that's okay. We're gonna deal with those in a moment. I'm gonna press OK. And you can see that the clouds are looking really good. And now we're going to use a mask to hide the elements that are spilling over onto the building and the street and the cars. So I'm going to click on this icon here to create a layer mask. With layer mask, you can paint with black to hide pixels or paint with white to reveal them. I'm going to undo those brush strokes to start with a clean mask, meaning the mask is completely white. Then I can paint with black in areas here in the building that are showing some of that blue. One thing you can do is click on the polygonal lasso tool and just make a very rough selection around the areas that you do not want that background to show through. I'm just quickly making this selection. Then I can fill with black. Black is my foreground color, so I can press Alt and Backspace, Option, Backspace on the Mac. If I come over into the layer mask icon, I can hold Alt and you will see what my mask looks like. Everything in black is being hidden and everything in white is being shown. I'm going to hold Alt again and click on the layer mask icon to bring that back. So now we have the before sky and the after. There's a little bit of the original mountains coming through from the clouds layer that I'm not liking. So I can click on my brush again, make sure that I have a brush with the hardness set to 0, which is a soft brush. Then I can make the brush bigger by clicking on the right bracket key on the keyboard and just painting with black to hide those pixels. So now we only have the clouds in our image. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Don't forget to check out the rest of my Amazon video shorts at ptcvids.com/Amazon. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.